Hello guys, I am Mohan. Let's talk about Havells and the Indian Watts. So these are the topics that we will discuss today. Indian sculptures, which are highly original and creative, could be ranked with the most noblest creations of the West by Ernest Winfield Havells. So it's about Havells. Ernest was born at Jesse Terrace in the country of Berkshire in 1861. The son of an artist, Charles Richard Havell, and his wife, Charlotte Amelia Rod. The family hired several artists and publishers, even began reading school and learned art at the Royal College of Art in Paris and Italy. So in 1884, in India, Havell initially served the Madras School of Art as superintendent for 5 decades, and he served in 1890, and he joined as the superintendent of Government School of Art, Calcutta, the next day. In 1910, he was involved in the founding of the Indian Society along with William Rothenstein as a reaction to negative remarks made by George Greenwood on Indian art. Travels in India, he spent years of experience brought him closer to Swadeshi doctrines of Indian art and culture. First step was to abolish the British system of teaching. He remarked that in India, painting must be Indian in attitude and spirit. Havell included Oriental art in curriculum. He also introduced several new craft techniques such as fresco decoration for walls, stained glass windows. With art appreciation, he faced strong opposition from the British regime, though he continued his crusade for pushing the ideals of the Indian art. Later, he succeeded in convincing them of the importance of reviving the Indian craft tradition. It was Havell who introduced the fly shuttle boom in India in 1905. Havell argued that handcrafts should be fostered along with the architecture. Havell called for unification of art. Sculpture should be viewed in its architectural context and not to be seen in isolation. His books and papers threw fresh insights into Indian art and architecture. His book, Benares, the Sacred City, Sketch of Hindu Life and Religion, describes Benares as the microcosm of the Indian culture. On Indian aesthetics, Havell's two books, Indian Sculpture and Painting and Ideals of Indian Art, were a breakthrough in Indian art history. Abhinandanath Tagore once said, Havell shaped my son, he has my reference as a guru. Often, he would appear as collaborator, sometimes as a friend even. Perception on artistic nationalism titled The Basis of Artistic and Industrial Revival in India first appeared in the Hindu 1920. Havell left India in 1905. On sick leave and was later declared unfit for service in India by the British regime. Thank you.